Kia ora, I'm Fraser.
Kia ora, I'm Kia.
And this is StudyTime's Level 1 Strategy video for Mechanics.
Mechanics throws a lot of different concepts at you, but it can really be broken down into three topics: motion, forces, and energy.
There are going to be conceptual-based questions, there are going to be graph questions, and there are going to be calculation questions. If you follow the strategies we're about to discuss, you'll definitely be able to come out on top.
Let's get into it. Interpreting graphs is a big part of the standard, particularly distance-time graphs and speed-time graphs. When you're interpreting graphs, always make sure to refer to specific numbers. For example, don't just say John sped up at the beginning of his journey. Say John's velocity increased from 14 meters per second to 20 meters per second in the first 5 seconds of his journey. As a part of that, practice doing graph-based calculations, such as finding the average speed on a distance-time graph and finding the distance on a speed-time graph.
One thing to definitely try and understand is the formula sheet. This doesn't mean just what each letter means, but also the units and also what each of the formulas are actually talking about. Just a quick side note that one of the really common mistakes is mixing up pressure and power because both have the letter capital P, so definitely make sure you know which formula is which. For excellence questions, you are going to have to use two or three formulas in a row. So a good way of getting around this is to write down what you've been given and also what you want to find out. Then look at your formula sheet and see how you could get from one to the other.
Concept-based questions might seem tricky, but a good counterintuitive tip to remember is to write down the relevant formulas even if they say that calculations aren't needed. This is because you can sort of tell by the letters in the formula what's happening to what it is that you're trying to work out. For example, in the formula pressure equals force over area, if the force is increasing, that means that the pressure is also increasing. Another common question that is asked is to differentiate mass and weight. Remember, the difference between mass is that mass is the amount of matter in an object given in kilograms, whereas weight is the downwards force due to gravity in newtons. This just illustrates the importance of knowing the definitions of concepts in mechanics.
One last thing to really have nailed down is gravitational potential energy and kinetic energy and the relationship between them. If you're holding a ball above the ground, all of its energy is gravitational potential. When you start to drop it, some of that gravitational potential gets converted into kinetic energy until right before it hits the ground, where it's all kinetic energy. This type of explanation is really, really common, so make sure you have it nailed down. One last thing that they can tack on for excellence is about how the theoretical value you just calculated doesn't match the actual value that happened. Remember that kinetic energy and gravitational potential energy can be lost as different forms of energy, usually heat or sound from the ball bouncing. All in all, everything in the standard comes down to either motion, forces, or energy.
We've covered a lot in this video, but we still haven't covered everything. So if you want more information, head onto our website and check out our walkthrough guides, free online, or if you want an in print, you can have it ready for next day delivery. That's all from us. Thanks for watching.